Spotify, the world's largest streaming platform, will soon be changing the way that some artists receive royalties. And for some, that means being paid nothing at all. The changes, which will be implemented early next year, include a new threshold of minimum annual streams that a track must meet before it starts to generate royalties. The threshold, according to Music Business Worldwide, will demonetize tracks that had previously received 0.5% of Spotify's royalty pool. There will also be financial penalties for music distributors and labels when fraudulent activity on tracks they have uploaded to Spotify has been detected. And there will be a new minimum playtime length for non-music noise tracks, such as bird sounds or white noise, that new floor they must reach to generate royalties. And while that 0.5% number seems rather small, it's critical to understand how lopsided Spotify's royalty structure already is. And this is according to Tim Ingham of Rolling Stone. Digging around on Spotify's royalty explainer loud and clear offers some insight into just how unforgiving the minimum requirements of success have become. Spotify proudly tells us that 57,000 artists currently share 90% of the royalties it pays out. In 2020, Spotify paid out around $5 billion in recorded music and publishing royalties. 90% of that would be $4.5 billion. So the 57,000 acts shared this money are what we can justifiably call Spotify's gold club. They represent just 0.8% of the total artists on this platform. Now, to put it into perspective, there are over 11 million artists who publish music on Spotify, and these changes could have a devastating effect for artists living in the margins of an already brutal industry or artists who are just trying to get started. Now, the Union of Musicians and Allied Workers was just trying to become the de facto union for musicians, had this to say. Artists have solutions to fix streaming, but Spotify isn't listening. Instead, they propose changes that will enrich the top of the pyramid even more and make it even more impossible for working musicians to benefit from streaming. The tech platforms and major labels who got us in this mess aren't going to lead us out of it. Artists need to make their voices heard to fix streaming. Now, it's really brutal. I mean, I think everyone, think about the last time you bought an album. Maybe you collect vinyl, but for the most part, most listeners stream music. Artists barely receive anything from that. Most of their money comes from touring, which is another predatory industry. So this, if they could get something for streaming, it could benefit them. But Ben and Mondale, I'd like to bring you in here. I mean, what do you make of this? This just seems like a reflection of an already lopsided broader US economy. I mean, what do you think should be done? Ben, we can go to you first.
It's wild. I never will understand how companies that are already multi-billion dollar companies that already have, aside from the moral cost of not taking care of the very people who make their platform make all of that money, the talent, the artists, the performers, the producers, the people who actually create the work, the writers, and reduce it further, aside from that being morally bankrupt, it's a PR nightmare for these people. I just don't understand it. I have stuff on Spotify. I barely get any money for it. My stand-up comedy's on there. I barely get anything. And they for a long time weren't wanting to not even pay comedians for both being the performer and the writer. They wanted them just to get paid once when every other artist or type of performance rather gets both the writer gets paid and the performer gets paid. And they just try to nickel and dime so much when they're making enormous profits. It's really disgusting. And I'm also an actor currently on strike in the SAG strike, and streaming residuals is a huge part of the strike. And they don't even want to tell us the numbers that TV shows and movies get on streaming platforms. In every instance, these huge companies that make their money on the back of artists do not want to appreciate those artists. And look, you're entitled to pay whatever amount of money you think is a fair offer when you start a business, and somebody can take that amount of money and accept it. And if that's less than you know you could afford to pay, okay, it's your prerogative to do that. But then when the artists en masse protest it and say, we can't live on this, turns out it's way too little. We need more, and you clearly have more to share. Can you please share just a more fair piece of the pie? and you fight it tooth and nail, let alone reducing it, you're disgusting. You're a morally bankrupt person. And I don't see how possibly you can justify continuing to even look yourself in the mirror when you are unwilling to share the spoils of the other people's labor, not really even yours.
Yeah, I'm confused at like where, at what point does this become criminal, right? Like at what point do we get to say you violating the contract? Because in 2011, in July, I remember the summer when Spotify came, they said they were gonna be a place that protect artists from piracy. They called themselves a creative hub. This is a place for a home for creatives. This does not seem like that unless they're talking about people creative enough to find more ways to steal from people struggling. The absolute fact that 57,000 people shared in 90% of their monies, and there's so many other artists who got nothing, is absolutely disgusting to me. And I think there needs to be a lawyer that's creative enough to find a lawsuit against these people who told us that 11 million people in Europe couldn't be wrong about their platform, about how great it was for not just the listener, but also for the artist, how it'd be home for the artist. But in actuality, we just see you're stripping people of their way of making a living to even survive. I'm disgusted with Spotify, and I have absolutely, and it doesn't mean anything to them, pull myself off of that platform because of it.
The piracy point, I think, is an interesting one, because when Napster came about, I'm sure both of you remember that, many people watching, Metallica was one of the most outspoken critics of Napster because they said it would hurt artists. And people focused on the messenger and not the message. Now we're living in an environment where nobody's buying albums, even though that was kind of a new technology. Nobody's really buying albums. And most of the money comes from touring, like I mentioned. And even there, you're dealing with like price gouging because Live Nation controls the ticketing, controls the venues, controls the promotions, and also, oh, the shirts that you sell, like the one way you make your money living, we're going to take a cut of that now too. They just rolled out a tiny proposal that some venues won't take merch cuts, but it doesn't fix the problem. They're basically just clothing salespeople who also sing songs. And we need to rethink how we structure this industry, how we compensate people in that industry, because you're going to see a lot of really, really talented musicians just go on to other careers because they can't afford to make ends meet. And we'll all lose out because of that.
This is why I stopped rapping.
Wait, you rap?
I did used to rap for a hot minute. And I
realized, give me a bar, Ben.
Well, it's actually kind of a perfect, if I can give you the first bar of one of my better songs. I'm anti-social media, it's mean to you and it's fleeting, hell. Wait, some cats that's eating you, or adorable babies beating you, and it cheapens you. Virility, the great con. Oh, now you look up from your phone, why? The internet broke, huh? There it is.
I love it.
Thank you very much.
I love it. I love it. You should go to a battle rap league.
I'm open to it. I'm open to it. I've done a rap battle show before, and I lost. I lost pretty bad. I'm good at it, but I have to be more stoned for my raps to really flow, and then it's hard to kind of get the peak right, you know?
Yeah, you got to be like, I done dug that through slugs at, where the thugs at, came back, asked for the loves at, and all I got was hug cats, because y'all is small town like the Rugrats.
Yeah. Something like that. Yes. Jordan, your turn.
Good. I'm good. I'll just judge.
Look, if you're good, then hit us with it. But I mean, you know, in all seriousness, like that's not the point, but like we are artists because we become artists because we want to create, we want to entertain. It's supposed to be something that brings such light and joy to the world. Like we just got to experience a little stupid moment of right there. And then these platforms come and they monetize it for us, which is great and which we need. They give artists, and the promise of streaming is so amazing because it enables small artists that aren't signed by labels to publish and to be able to find an audience. And all you gotta do then is just give a fair split. You know, I run a virtual comedy club. It's the world's first virtual comedy venue called Nowhere Comedy we created during the pandemic. And the splits that we give to artists are a minimum of 60% to the artist, usually 70 or higher. And so that's the way, you gotta be artists first. You gotta make sure that the talent understands that they are why your business exists. People that do it the opposite, it's just gross.
I also think there's something powerful about that 60%, 70% split, because what happens is I guarantee you would generate better content. You would have more artists with more freedom to create the at their highest level, at their peak, freeing them from the stresses of doing other things that they're not called to do. And if we are honest about music being the greatest collaborator or bringer of people, communion of people, I think we should really think about what the union said when we said that word of pyramid. We have to look into this. This seems like a pyramid scheme where only the people at the top are eating and everybody else is just there for white noise, no pun intended. Yeah. It's absolutely disgusting. Really, it is.
100%. And the reason that we give big splits and that you got to give big splits like that is it's just the very obvious fact. The artist only makes money on their own art. And the person that owns the company makes money on millions of artists potentially as they grow. And so you don't need the lion's share times millions. You can take a small piece times millions and everybody wins.
Hey, thanks for watching that video. We really appreciate it, guys. And we appreciate it if you become members because that allows us to be independent, honest, progressive, all the things that you don't get from corporate media. And all of that is because of you guys. Hit the join button below and become one of us. Become a Young Turk.